everyone. So today I'm going to be doing my first resin geode. This took me about a month to do, and even longer than that if you count the time it took me to put the video together. And so I've been waiting a long time to show this to you guys, and I'm so glad that that time is finally here. The first thing I'm using is crushed mirror glass, which will add like a shadow and some depth underneath the clear fire glass. This is the main crushed glass that I'm using in this piece today. I am using a few different kinds, but this is Celestial Diamond Starlight 1/4 inch non-reflective fire glass. I got it from Amazon. This is what it looks like up close. I will have links for all of the products I'm using in this piece today down below in the description. And I'm making sure to cover up the mirror glass with this Diamond Starlight fire glass, because I don't want the mirror glass to show on top, but I want it to be like a shadow underneath. I am also going to add some clusters of these genuine clear quartz crystal points that I got also from Amazon. And it is actually best to use a hot glue gun, but I did not have a hot glue gun yet. And so at first I'm using E6000 adhesive, but then I ended up getting a hot glue gun, and I go back in later and add a couple more quartz points to my clusters. Next, I am adding some colored crushed glass, and I actually colored all of this crushed glass myself. It's crushed mirror glass that I use. If you would like to know how I did that, then you can actually go check out the very beginning of my video number 25, and it explains it and shows it and everything. So I did like an indigo color first, and then like a more vivid blue, and then I actually ended up going back in later and adding a little bit of purple. I also want to show you something that you won't see in the video. It's this iridescent, it's either crushed glass or this like crushed stone type stuff, but it kind of reminds me of white opal, and I added a lot of that on top of my crushed glass. To secure all the crushed glass in place, I am drizzling the resin over it with my silicone stir stick or silicone spatula. You want to be quite thorough with this, but you don't want to pour the resin like from the cup over your glass, because then your glass will really lose its sheen and its shimmer and its, you know, whatever twinkle it has. Now, some people put the resin underneath and then put the crushed glass on top. I personally would not recommend this because that takes away the freedom you have to move the crushed glass around and all that when you're in the process of deciding where exactly you want it to go. And then I'll remove that green tape once that glass is pretty secure to the canvas.
Thank you.
so as you can see, it's not anywhere close to being done yet, but I had to take a break on this particular day for now because my resin was starting to not be workable anymore. So once it hardened, I took that opportunity to add this stuff and this stuff. What it is glitter glass and this confetti polyester glitter. By drizzling that on top of the bigger chunks of crushed glass, it adds this amazing twinkly shimmer that you wouldn't have had otherwise. And it's way more than the glass itself is able to offer. And it makes it gorgeous. It makes it amazing. And it really makes it come to life. Now, when you do this, you have to make sure that your resin is hardened first, because some of the pieces of the glitter and the glass will get where they're not supposed to go because they just, you know, bounce off and get everywhere else. And so make sure that, one, your resin is hard, and that also you have gotten all those little pieces off before you continue, pouring resin, especially if your flood coat is the, you know, what you're pouring next, which is, it wasn't in my case, but you know, these are some very, very important things, because otherwise that little piece is going to be embedded in there forever. As I mentioned earlier, I am using my new hot glue gun to add some more quartz points to the clusters that I already put there earlier, but just to make them stick up a little more noticeably above the crushed fire glass. I also drizzled these tiny little acrylic crystals that resemble tiny cubic zirconia within and right around both of my clusters of the quartz points, because when the light reflects off them, it reflects in like a rainbow shimmer, and I love the way that looks, and it just adds a very interesting, like, beautiful but really subtle detail to the quartz clusters and the overall piece itself.
Thank you.
I did hot glue some fire glass and crushed glass to the sides so that they would match the tops. And next is the final flood coat, and is the best part. And before I do the actual flood coat itself, though, I did give all the areas that have crushed glass a little bit more volume by adding quite a bit more. And so to secure those in place, I am drizzling more resin on top, and I'm also making sure to get resin on the sides very well where there's where I hot glue that crushed glass, so that they don't pop off, because if you don't resin them down, they will end up popping off sooner rather than later. And then after I drizzled that resin, I also reapplied some of the glitter glass and some of more of the polyester, the iridescent glitter. I have to say, this is definitely the piece that I am most proud of out of all of the ones that I have done. And I would love to hear what all of your opinions are, any input, you know, that you have, whatever you want to share. Please let me know down below in the comments. If you like this video, please hit that like button, and obviously subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. It really helps me out, and I love knowing how many supporters I have out there. And the resin flood coat, by the way, it came out so perfectly glass-like smooth, and I couldn't be happier with this. So thank you so much for watching, and stay tuned for the next video. Bye.